Hello everyone, my name is Jennifer Stay, this is Coloring Bliss, and today we're going to talk about the perfect pencil sharpener, or at least my hunt for the perfect sharpener. I've got 7 criteria that I want my pencil sharpener to do, so we're going to talk about those 7 criteria, talk about all the different kinds of pencil sharpeners I'm currently using and have used, although we'll do that really fast, because what I want to get to is the 2 brand new pencil sharpeners that I brought in to test and see if they are my new perfect pencil sharpener. Let's get started. Okay, back here by Little Rose, I have a display of all of my collection, my current collection of pencil shavings. I love to collect them, save them. I think they're beautiful. One, my favorite jar, let me show you, is this one right here. It's all white pencil sharpenings from when we did our battle of the white color pencils. Love that jar, so much fun. So yeah, I have a wee bit of experience with sharpening pencils. And my current favorite pencil sharpener of everything I've ever tried is the Humble and Basic Coombe. I'll show you that one right here. I like the 2-hole sharpener right here. So this is my current favorite. And the reason I like it is because it's small, it's portable, it's super sharp. So you can sharpen even delicate pencils like pastel pencils and the Prismacolors. They almost always get sharpened beautifully and perfectly using this little guy right here. I like this pencil sharpener so much that my son, Carter, he is almost 18 now, isn't he? He has made me a bunch of Coombe sharpeners with gorgeous stones on the top. Look at that. So it's a basic Coombe sharpener on the bottom, and then he has put these really pretty stones. This one is a geode. I guess this was one of his childhood favorite geodes that he turned into a pencil sharpener for me. This is a rock that we actually collected. You and the boys collected this rock.
Bubble opal.
Yeah, it's so cool. So I have a lot. You can see he's done several purple versions because he knows that's my favorite color. And I keep telling him he needs to produce these and sell them because I think everybody would like a little gem like this as like a treasure that's actually practical. So comment below if you want me to keep nagging him to make these for all of you. I also have in here probably my 2nd most favorite color, pencil sharpener, this little Alvin brass bullet. But we're going to talk a lot about all the different kinds I've tried. But before we do that, as much as I love the Coombe, it doesn't meet all 7 of my standards. So let me show you and share with you what 7 standards I'm trying to meet with my pencil sharpeners. Okay, the 7 things I want out of my pencil sharpener, and we're going to kind of talk about the Coombe as we go through this, and you'll see why it hits almost all of these. Effective, it creates a sharp point. Definitely with the Coombe, it's got the German blade in it, so it's a dependable blade. And the 2-hole I like because if you have a fat, chubby color pencil, you can use that one. Or if you don't ever use that big hole, this is a spare blade ready to be swapped into that position when it feels a little dull. So effective, super effective at getting a sharp point. Expeditious. I tried to find one word to to relate everything on that one point. So expeditious. I want it to be fast. I have a lot of color pencils. For instance, I have this little pouch here. This is my emergency Prismacolor color pencil set that I take with me in my purse at all times. And in here I have a tiny little Coombe it's called the Ellipse, the Coombe Ellipse. And this is the one that comes with me everywhere I go, but it holds almost no pencil shavings. Like you can sharpen maybe 2 pencils and then this little cavity down here is full and it jams up and makes it hard to sharpen. But it works fine for the purpose, which is on the go, quick sharpening. But as you can see right now, all of them except for these last 3 here really need sharpening. And if I were to sit down with my little Coombe and sharpen all of these in one sitting, it's going to take a while. They'll all be perfect and beautiful when I'm done, but it's going to take a while. So expeditious, not so much. versatile. So versatile refers to different types of pencils. We have everything from Crayola with its really tough core that's easy to sharpen, to graphite pencils, to pastel pencils, which are really crumbly, to the Prismacolors, which are notorious for being difficult to sharpen. Can my sharpener do all of those? And yes, this little coon can do them all. So it's so very versatile. Now the next one is adaptable. Can it adjust for a variety of pencil sizes and shapes? We've got circular pencils, triangular pencils, hexagonal pencils, square pencils, and then we've got short little stubby ones, like maybe you've been using it for a while and there's only a little bit left. Some of those pencils can be really tricky to sharpen because there's not much left. Yeah, so is this guy adaptable? Yes, the coom can do any of those that I mentioned, which is fantastic. So
including the fat ones like the
Albrecht Dürer Magnus watercolor pencils that I love, those fit in this big fat hole too.
What was that one that we did recently that were really big and fat? Was it Criticolor?
Yeah, the Criticolors. Good memory.
Oh, thank you.
I'm impressed.
Did it work on those?
I think so. I bought a special Criticolor color pencil sharpener because they recommended that when I purchased it, but I found out that this hole also will work. So
nice.
It's very good. Okay, dependable. Very few problems and easy to maintain. I don't want to spend my time fixing a pencil sharpener when I want to be sharpening a pencil and getting to my art project. So again, the coom is fantastic. I mean, it's just three, well, I guess if you count the screws, we have 2, 4, 5 pieces that make this up. A magnesium body that doesn't degrade or break down, and 2 really awesome blades that are really easy with a tiny little screwdriver to undo and clean.
Yeah.
I mean, that's pretty dependable to me. And maintenance for this little guy, all you need to do is run like a little graphite or a number 2 pencil through it, and the graphite in that pencil will clean the blade and make it work a lot better. That's a really important tip. We're going to talk more about graphite here in a minute. We're going to try something with graphite. Okay, portable. Can it be used in multiple locations? This is so important because I color in the truck. I color in this my sofa. I color here in my art studio. I sometimes color in bed. And sometimes with my little nieces and nephews on the floor. I've got to be able to take a good pencil sharpener with me everywhere. And the coom does a really good job, except for storing the pencil shavings. So typically when I am out and about, not here in the art studio, I have a tiny little disposable plastic container that I keep this in. And then when I do the sharpening, those shavings will fall into that container. But here in the art studio, when I'm working with my coom, I just use a little dish. This is actually, I think, a soap dish I got from, I don't know if it was Walmart or the dollar store. It's just a little nice dish that I like, and it's nice and wide, and I can sharpen right into it. And then the sharpening, oh, Steve found the container. This is the container I use when I'm out and about with my coom. And then when I'm done with the shavings, I put them into jars because I think they're pretty, and I have a lot of artistic ideas of what I want to do with all these shavings someday. Okay, so yes, this one is very portable and quiet. It's not discreet, and it's unoffending to a certain furry creature that's sitting right there. So this is kind of important. I want the pencil sharpener to be quiet because sometimes I'm maybe at church and I'm sitting in a pew and I need to sharpen a pencil and I don't want the whole room to hear me sharpening. So it needs to be very discreet. Now, little Rose, she's finally calmed down, but here in a minute, as I start touching these other pencil sharpeners, you're going to see her get more and more agitated. She is not just, she doesn't just sort of dislike these pencil sharpeners, she's afraid of them. And I need a pencil sharpener that doesn't offend Rose. So that's really important. I've got it as number 7 because it needs to be quiet. And we're going to talk about this little guy right here that I got that is an electric one. And we're going to kind of compare the sounds that they make. And then I have 2 brand new pencil sharpeners that we're going to unbox together and see, after doing a ton of research, we're going to see if those are quieter than this guy right here and if it's something that Rose can talk tolerate. When we get to the testing part, I'm going to send her out so we don't upset her and bring her back just to let her hear the one that we choose as the least noisy. That's my plan with these new ones that we're going to unbox. So we'll see how that goes. Okay, so now you can see why the Coombe is one of my favorite pencil sharpeners, and the Alvin Brass Bullet is sort of in the same category because it's small, has a German blade, it's very dependable, but it doesn't work with as many different types of pencils, so as far as number 3 and 4, the versatile and adaptable, it's not quite as good as the good old Coombe. So I'm going to put a link to the Coombes and as many of these pencil sharpeners as I possibly can into this video in case you see one that you want to purchase and try. So let me give you a very fast tour of all of the different types of pencil sharpeners I've tried over the years. I'm not going to go into too much detail on them because I want to get to unboxing the new pencil sharpeners. So let's take a look. She's starting to get nervous, you see? She moved away. She'll get to a point where she actually turns and puts her nose and her head back in the corner, way back there, because it protects her ears. But see how she's facing the wall. She doesn't want to be part of any of this that she sees in front of me. Okay, really quick, let me show you a whole bunch of things that I have tried over the years. Everything from things that aren't technically pencil sharpeners. This is a cuticle remover, and this, or not a cuticle, a callus remover. And this is a sandpaper block is what this is. I've tried these. I've tried this. This one is decent. The Staedtler pencil sharpener. It's decent. Has two holes and a little carrying compartment. So that's fantastic. This is that twist and sharpen one where you put it in here and it has a ratcheting motion and it twists like this. So you can hold the pencil steady and then move the pencil sharpener, which I thought would be really good, but it's not. This one just works intermittently, and I think it's because of all the plastic pieces that just don't work great. Here is another one. This was just a cheap one that I picked up, I think, at Walmart that I wanted to try. Again, it comes down sometimes to just the blade. The body and everything may be plastic, but if it's got a really good German blade in it, then you might have a winner in your hand. Okay, here's a different size Coombe right here. It's just a single hole. These are great too. In fact, in some ways, I think they're more ergonomic because of the way they've been designed. But I love the two hole because it gives me more versatility. There's another Coombe. You're going to see I have Coombes everywhere. This one's like a Coombe lookalike, but it doesn't have the made in Germany on the blade. So I've never even bothered opening the little guy up. I think these were gifted to me. Then I've tried, I think, 3 different versions of the Dahle. And I know a lot of you love this little guy right here. The idea behind the Dahle is that you can get different sized points. A tiny little cone up to a really tall cone. And I think that's a pretty cool idea. But again, it's all plastic parts. And the blade inside is not a German-made blade. And so it just, it kept failing on me. So I've bought, I think, 3 over the years because you guys keep saying, no, it was just a faulty one. Try again. Okay, now we have 2 more Coombes. And you know I've got that other Coombe I showed you earlier. So this different Coombe styles, I really, every time I see one, I try it. This one is got a little plastic container to catch shavings. And the only reason I haven't opened this one up yet is because I'm kind of thinking of giving it to one of my nieces or nephews next time they're over. This is the Coombe Long Point. And I have a video on a lot of these. The Coombe Long Point, I have a video on. The point of the Coombe Long Point is that it does a 2-step sharpening. The first step gets rid of the wood and reveals the pencil, and then the second step sharpens up that tip of that graphite to a super, super point. It's really a cool thing, but it's not exactly what you need for color pencils. I think it's more for graphite artists. So this is a good one, and it's fun to try if you want to try another one. And this is just a basic cheap color a pencil sharpener that I have. Now I've also tried using a knife, and this is my current knife that I like. I like it because the blades are replaceable. In fact, the blades are right here. stored in the handle. So when I'm ready to do a new blade, I can just pull it out and put it in. I like it because it has this thumb resting spot. So as long as I have all four fingers there and my thumb there, then I'm pretty safe as far as cutting myself. I just don't drop it or be aware of your other hand. Using a knife is, a lot of artists swear by it because they can get that point of their pencil to exactly the way they want it. The cone the right shape and the tip the right sharpness. I find myself pretty clumsy with this and I don't trust myself. So I use these for very particular situations, like sometimes the pastel pencils. We're not talking the color pastel, we're talking actual chalk pastels in the center of the pencils. This is a really good tool for those particular pencils. So yeah, I do use it, but it's still not perfect because it's not very dependable. Well, that's not the right word. Which one? I'm not very fast at it yet. I need to practice. Versatile. It does do a ton of different pencil types, and you can adjust for any shape or size. And it's portable, but I don't know if I'd want to be doing this in church. Can't take it on a plane. You'd get in trouble on a plane. Yeah, so there's a lot of downsides, one of which is I can never remember how to close this thing. I'm going to carefully hand it to my husband and let him figure it out. I just need to...
back there. You push.
Oh, okay, let me show them. It's this right here. That's why it's not very obvious. You push it and it clicks right in. So it's really a good little thing because it's got all your blades. But yeah, I just need to practice with that one. Okay, now we're getting into a few others. And we're going to talk about Carl here. Carl's been one of my favorite pencil sharpeners. Is it effective? Does it get a sharp point? Oh yeah. Is it fast? One of my fastest. I love it. Is it versatile? Pretty good. The mouth is your sort of choke point. Whether you can fit a pencil in there or not just depends on if it's a big enough mouth. So versatile, yeah, that's pretty good. Adaptable for different variety of pencil sizes and shapes. Oh, and types. So versatile and adaptable sort of work together, as I probably could have gotten away with putting them as the same thing. And this little guy, I've done everything in there that I possibly can try, and I think that's why I have a problem, because right now he's not dependable. He isn't sharpening at all, and we're going to take him apart here in a second and see what's going on. I have a feeling something's jammed up into the helix blades.
But it's been dependable for a long
time.
Several years, right?
Yeah, I've had him for a long time. He creates this kind of pencil shaving, which I don't save. These all get trashed because I don't think they're pretty. And so this one thing I don't like is I don't get my pretty collectible pencil shavings. But I'm willing to trade that for something that's fast and works well. Is it portable? Yeah, because he's not electric, but he's big. He couldn't fit in my purse. If I tried to haul him around in my purse, my husband would be mad because he's heavy. He's made out of steel and a little bit of plastic. But yeah, he's pretty good. Now, the other thing I hate about Carl is that he's sort of bitey. So his little mouth right there, when you sharpen any pencil with it, let's see if this one's been sharpened in the Carl. No, let's just do it right. Oh, I can't because he's broken right now.
Puts those little teeth marks in it.
Yeah, he puts little bite teeth marks onto the pencils. And that's, you know, if you've got a really expensive... Some of these pencils are like $5 and $6 a pop. I don't want bite marks on a really expensive pencil. If it was just a cheap Crayola, who cares if it gets bite marks, right? Okay, this is the next thing I tried. It's also got the helix blades on it, and I have a video of when I unboxed this and showed it to you. And this guy is battery powered, so you have to charge him up. It came with a USB cable that I have to keep track of. So is he effective? He was for a while. Was it fast? Oh yeah, it's really fun. Let me show you. If I do this pencil here. Oh, are you ready, Rose, for your first noise? See? Oh, there it goes. See? Pretty fast. and we get a really nice sharpened point. So that's fantastic. But the problem is Miss Rose hates it. Anytime she sees me pull this out from off of its shelf, she usually goes in the back corner and hides. And I don't want her to be scared. She's my really important coloring companion, and I want her to feel comfortable and safe here in this space. In fact, she was so scared, we had to retrain her to come back to sit with me, because she thought, every time I sit down here, she's going to pull out these noisy things, and I hate them. So it's a real problem. So it's not super portable. It's not super dependable because this hole is so small. So not all my pencils will fit in there, and it gets jammed easy. So over time, I have felt like this one is not the best. It was a good price for what it was. I don't even think it's available anymore on Amazon. So I must not have been the only one having an issue with this one. But we may open this one up too and look and see if it's got a problem and if that's why it's not working as dependably. Huh, I got it. Okay, so that takes you really quickly through my journey with pencil sharpeners. Have you tried any of these? Did you have the same experience, or did I just shoot down one of your absolute favorite pencil sharpeners? Comment below, I'd like to know. But now I'm going to show you the two brand new pencil sharpeners I purchased. And there's a third option we're going to try that's really weird, but we're going to try it anyway. All right, I have three things that I have purchased that I want to try. We've got an X-Acto pencil sharpener here that I did a ton of research on for something that was not too loud, and we'll see. I have no idea. We've got a Dahle pencil sharpener here, which is very similar to the Carl, but I have been recommended to purchase this many times by all of you, so I'm excited to try that one. And then the third thing I bought that I want to try, it's actually not this drill, but it goes with this drill. It's this little part. And what this is called is a deburring graphite tool. And evidently what they do is, let's say you've got a wooden dowel, this is a wooden dowel, right? Okay. And you want to make it so that the dowel will fit into the hole easier. For that, you need a tool that takes off just a small amount around the edge of that dowel. And that's what this little thing is. And the little deburring tool comes in a variety of shapes and sizes. This is the one that I thought would be closest to a pencil sharpener. I don't think it's gonna work, you guys, but we're gonna try it anyway. So I had Steve bring over my giant roll of pencils. If you remember this from our video, let's see, it was April Fool's Day, huh? That we did this giant roll of pencils, and I'm going to use these to test some of these new techniques. So the way this deburring tool works is it goes in here like that. Rose is already like, I'm out of here. Poor baby. Anyway, let's see how loud it is. Okay, it's working, and it's got sharp points on here, and I'm just wondering if I can, you know, when I was thinking of the fast, the expeditious number two criteria, I'm hoping this will be really fast, because I was like, if I have to sharpen all of these pencils, which it was over 500 pencils here, think how long it would take using the comb. It would take ages. Okay, we can't flip it that way. So let's just pick a random pencil here.
Do you want to have your Rosie?
Yeah, we're going to take her out and so she... She's so sad. It's just so sad. Rosie, you want to go with Daddy? Get out of here. When you come back, we'll give you a treat, okay? Okay, we'll see you in a little while. Oh, poor baby. We gotta solve this problem. Okay, let's see if this is going to work. I have small... I saw several YouTubers have tried different ways of using a power drill to do their pencil sharpening, but this... I just don't think it's gonna work. Yeah, see, it's just not the right size. So, I need to... I need to either find a smaller deburring tool or bit, or just give up on the idea of trying to use a power drill. So at least we know now that this particular one doesn't work, and I'll give it to my sons and they can use it in their workshop. Okay, let's take a look at this Dahle pencil sharpener. This one is a Helix pencil sharpener, just like the Carl and just like my other electric pencil sharpener. And this one, though, has really high reviews. Particularly, this is the Dahle 133. They have different versions. And I picked this one up for... Let me get my price out so I can tell you. I bought it for $21, and it's still available for that price. It comes with a little clamp, so if you want to clamp it to your desk, you can do that. But I typically just hold them like this and run the crank, and then I don't have to clamp it somewhere permanently. Right away, the Dahle is not made out of metal. It's made out of plastics. It's got a little tray to catch your shavings right here. And let's see, this is your mouth button to help open it wider to hold on to your pencil. And then on the back, we've got an adjustment. So I can either have a really sharp point or a more dull point. I always want sharp. So let's make sure it's turned all the way that way. Yep. We want sharp. Okay, so the way this works is you pull the face out, and the tension and springs that are there on the face is what's going to pull the pencil slowly into the blades to get the sharpening motion going. Now, this one also has the little teeth I already showed you, but they don't look as aggressive. They look like they have like rubber on them. So we'll see if we get some teeth marks. Okay, then you hold it steady with one hand, and away we go. You can see it's pulling it in slowly, and you don't have to keep sharpening it all the way to the moment that it reaches here. You can stop anytime you want. I'm just going to go all the way. It's going to take a lot off, but I want to see what it does. Okay, there, it's starting to spin now. Okay, so you push the button to release it and pull it out. And look at that, a beautiful sharp point. I can see why you guys like this. And no bite on the pencil body. That's really awesome. That worked really good. And let me show you, there's the pencil shavings. So if you look inside, let's see if I can, we'll look inside the Carl here in a minute and show you how those work. So that's the Dahle. So far, I like it. It was really quiet and pretty fast, so that's good. I'm hoping the Dahle will end up being my replacement for Carl, because Carl makes those bites on my pencils. So yay for Dahle. I'll keep this in case I ever do want to attach it to something. Okay, now let's open up this next box here. This one I'm really excited about. I spent some more money on this one. This one, when I purchased it, it was $30. I've seen it for as high as $54, and currently it's $25. So I think anywhere between $25 and $50 is how much you're going to find this being sold for on Amazon. Okay, I'm going to cut into this and we'll see what it looks like. Wow, this is a big beast. Look at it compared to Carl. It's probably 2-3 times as big as Carl is. It has a giant reservoir right here for holding all of your pencil shavings. It's got little plunger feet, suction cup feet, that's what they're called, so that it can hold on tight to the surface that you're working with. Let's see how well that works. Really good. Yeah, that's good. And then we've got different pencil holes that we can choose from, a couple triangles, and then a bunch of circles from anything from really thin to bigger. So we're going to test out several different kinds of pencils to see if they will work. Now, one of the disadvantages of this guy is that he has a cord. So he's not battery operated, but the battery operated pencil sharpener I have, the battery lasted a long time, but then all of a sudden it just would stop working. And if you're in the middle of a project, it was frustrating that it stopped working. So let me plug this in, grab a few different brands of pencils, and let's see how this one works. All right, I went over to my pencil stash and grabbed a whole bunch of different pencils in different sizes. This is just a standard color pencil right here. Let's see how this one works. And I think it'll fit in that smaller hole. So that adjustment works really easily. Let's see how it sounds. Oh, that one's too small. Wow, that was really fast. And I let go of it because I'm used to this one here where you put it in and it grips it and holds it and does the job for you and then it spits it out. But in this situation, you have to hold on. Let me grab a couple more from that huge 500 set and let's see how it works. Really fast. Okay, this is coming off. I'm not sure why. So fast. And it doesn't seem too loud. Let's do a sound comparison between this electric one and this electric one. And I'm going to make sure that's in all the way. It is. Okay. I'm going to give this one the little bit more sharpened one. So here's the first sound. Okay. And then here is the second one. I don't think it's much quieter. It's faster, maybe by twice as fast. In fact, let's time it and see which one is faster. I'm so curious. Get my timer up here. A stopwatch is what I want. It right there, and let's see what it does. I'll grab two more pencils. They're pretty even with their needing of sharpening. So here we go. See if I can do two things at once. Ready, set, go. So 4 seconds to sharpen a pencil in this one right here. Now let's see how fast it goes with this one. And I don't know how I'm going to do this one because you have to hold on. This is like complicated. Okay, here we go. 2 seconds. So that's half the time to sharpen here. So that would make it half as distressing to Rose. One way to look at it, I guess. Okay, so far I'm impressed with this, except that this thing here keeps coming undone in the middle of a sharpening. So either I'm not putting it in right, or we have a problem. Okay, so my thoughts right off, without putting this X-Acto pencil sharpener through its paces, which I'm going to be. In fact, I may just sit down and run 100 of them through there and see what it does. We'll do that here in a minute. But right now, my first impressions between these two is that they're about the same sound amount, but this one here, the X-Acto, is twice as fast, and it feels more substantial and sturdy, so that's good. But let's also try a different shape because we can do triangular here too. So I'm going to grab a triangular pencil. This one is by Arteza. And let's see if this one right here needs some sharpening. Oh, that one really needs sharpening. It's got a broken tip. And it's triangular shaped. So let's come on over here to the smallest triangular one and see how it goes. beautiful and easy. Wow, I'm kind of liking this. Okay, I also have a Staedtler pencils, which are triangular. Let's see how this one goes. If anything, I think the triangular ones are easier. You don't have to hold on to them quite so tight. So that's interesting. Now I also have a larger triangular pencil here. I believe these are triangles that are made for kids. They're by Stabilo. So let's grab one here. Yep, it's a triangle. So I don't think it won't fit in the smallest hole. So this is where I was excited about this one because it had a variety of triangles. That's awesome. The other thing that's happening is it's stopping the sharpening process. Even though I have the pencil pushed in, it's stopping when it feels like it's done. Let's do another one of these. If I go to the larger hole, how does it feel? Oh, it spins. Oh no, it got stuck. Definitely got to make sure you have the right size hole. Okay, that's awesome. I'm so excited. We'll test these pencils on some on the other one as well. Now, that's one problem I had with this one is that the hole wasn't big enough for some of my pencils, some of my normal pencils, and that was frustrating. Let's try some of my bigger pencils. First, let's try a square pencil. Let me get this out. This is the Ruppert 120 set. I believe these are the squares. Yep. Okay, let me grab one and we'll see how it does. I'm thinking in the circle. Let's try. No, it doesn't want to go in there. Still doesn't want to go in there. So I would need the biggest circle hole. I wonder if it would go into the triangular one. Let's try it. Okay, I'll just go to the biggest triangle. Yeah, that works too. Very cool. Okay, now let's try a big boy. We've got two to try. We've got the Creatacolor and the Faber-Castell Magnus. So let's start with Creatacolor. These are big boys. See how big? And so let's turn it to the biggest circle. This is actually a hexagonal pencil, as you can see right there. Okay, let's see. No! Okay, let's try the biggest triangle. No! Okay, so it won't do these big Creatacolor pencils. Too bad. Let's see if the Albrecht Dürer Magnus will fit. Okay, I'll just grab one here. And oh. So that fits in the triangle hole. Interesting. Let's try another one in the circular hole. These don't really need much sharpening. Nope, we've got to go into the triangle hole for that. Very interesting. Now let's try the Prismacolor pencils. They are notoriously finicky about being sharpened, so we'll see. And let's try this one right here. It's nice and blunt and needs some love. Let's try the smallest. It's perfect. It's perfect. Okay, what if we go into a middle circle? Really good. Okay, so it's doing really well. I think other than those really chubby Creatacolor pencils, I can do any pencil I have in my stash in here. Okay, we need to do a rose test and see how she feels about it for our criteria number 7, quiet and discreet and unoffending. Let me go get Rose.
Hi, baby. Come here.
I'll give you a treat. Are you ready for a treat? Okay, let's get you up here. Good girl. Whoops. All right, let's get you a treat. Now, I kind of hid away the other pencil sharpeners that she recognizes, so this X-Acto one is new to her, so hopefully she will be like, whatever, it's nothing that's going to be scary. And what I'm going to do, you got to do psychology here, right? Let's start with sharpening a pencil with the Coombe, which she doesn't mind the Coombe. Okay, good. Okay, so we'll sharpen a pencil here, and you guys watch Rose and see if she does okay. Okay, so I'm just going to sharpen it with the Coombe. Uh-oh, she's looking in the corner. She doesn't trust what's happening here. I don't blame you, little girl.
She's so smart. It's like she knows that you're sharpening pencils.
Yep. Okay, we did that. Now, I want to see how dramatic her reaction is to this guy right here. So I'm going to sharpen several in a row, and we'll see how she does. Here we go. So far, so good. What do you think? Do you need a treat for being so brave? A treat? Let's give you a treat for being so brave. Yeah. Well, she didn't hide. Did you guys see that? Like
it's,
I said,
it's not a high-pitched sound. That's nice.
Yeah. We decided it's about the same loudness as my other electric one, but this gets it done in half the time. The other one was 4 seconds. This one is only 2 seconds sharpen a whole pencil. So let's do another one now, shall we? That's my Tuscan red that always breaks. Oh, you need another treat? Okay, but you have to wait till I sharpen a pencil. Okay, here we go.
She doesn't like it, but she doesn't hate it.
You need a treat.
This is a great deal.
Yeah. Okay, let's try the Dahle now. Okay, so I'm going to just move this. And here's the Dahle, the other one we're practicing on. Steve, will you hand me a triangular shaped one? And we'll try a few different shapes because we haven't done that yet with the Dahle. While we're doing, oh, I did the wrong. Sorry about that, everybody. This one first and then this one. No, I did it wrong again. Steve will get it. Okay, so this is a Staedtler triangular pencil here. So you push, remember you push right here to open up the little pinchers that are here. And I've got this pulled out and here we go. Let's see how she reacts. This one's very quiet. Okay, it did a triangular pencil perfectly and very fast, I must
say.
Yeah,
and
she didn't even notice I was doing it. Okay, let's try. Will you hand me a fabric? Actually, I can grab that. And then while I'm getting this one, will you get out a create a color for us? Okay. Let's see. These really don't need sharpening, but at least we'll be able to test the size that it can do. Okay, pinch. Put it in. It fits. Oh, it's a little tricky. I wish the whole thing was taller. Oh, is that what's going on? Am I used to the taller? Oh, yeah. The Carl is about, an inch and a half taller than this. And that allows me to have my hand here, spin this, and not hit my fingertips on the table. So I can spin all I want. So that's one thing I would redesign if I was the Dahle people, would be to make it taller. Then you could have a bigger reservoir for shavings, too. So I would change that, because, yeah, that's a bit annoying. But wow, check out that killer tip on there. Okay, now Steve's got for me a Criticolor, which the X-Acto wouldn't do. Let's see if Dahle will do it. It so far. Yeah, so Dahle will do it. One more to try, Steve, is the Brutefooner squares. So that'll work. He's very versatile. Put this away in here. Okay. Steve's getting me one of the squares, the Brutefooners. Thank you. Okay, let's see how. Overall, I'm not very pleased with the plastic. It feels like if I'm too aggressive, we were going to have a problem. But perfect sharpening. Good. Okay, I think we've tried enough in here to give me a feeling about this guy right here. So far, I like that he has rubber teeth, so he's not leaving a mark on any of my pencils. That solves the problem from the Carl. I don't like that he's shorter and stouter, because my hand, as I'm working this, let me see if I can get it from that angle. There we go. When you come around this side, can you see how close my fingertips are to the table? And when you just are doing it, my fingers are hitting every time and it doesn't feel natural. So in, to show you the difference here, we've got a bigger reservoir for more shavings and I can freely go without hitting the table. So yeah, I'm not a very big fan of this one yet, except for the rubber teeth, and I can fit my big jumbo pencils in there. That's pretty cool. Oh my goodness. Okay, we're gonna do a speed run of 100 pencils in this bad boy right here, because I want to see how it performs when it gets hot, and as I just run pencils through it, does it stay sharp? All that good stuff. So let's do a time lapse, and I'm gonna run a whole bunch of pencils. We'll see how Rose reacts. I'm gonna start with my Prismacolors, then we'll move into the big set behind me, the 500 set. All right, time lapse start. All right, that was like 3 Prismacolor pencils and it jammed, you guys. Let's see if I can see what's going on here. It's pretty messy on the inside, but that's to be expected. Is there something stuck on it? Okay, I ran a graphite pencil through it and it seems to be working again. Let's try another Prismacolor pencil here. I'm thinking that the Prismacolors are too soft for this boy here, which is frustrating because they're my favorite. And as you can see, Rose is getting more and more anxious here. Let me see if I can give her a treat, if that will help her. Or is, you know, does she want a treat? Or does she want to get out of here, you know? At least she's not sitting with her nose in the corner. Okay. Do you need to get down? Oh, yeah. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna keep going here and give you my opinion after I run a whole bunch through here. Now, one of the reasons I picked this particular pencil sharpener is because it says in the literature that it's meant for heavy use, like in a school. So by sharpening a whole bunch of pencils in a row like this, I'm hoping to see what happens when the motor gets warm. How many can I do without having to worry about any maintenance? All that good stuff. How many pencils, sharpening, shavings will the bin hold? And I'm sticking with some of my most difficult to sharpen. I did the Prismacolor Premieres, and now I've moved on to the Scholars by Prismacolor, which have a harder core, so they're not as difficult to sharpen, but it will still be a really good test of color pencils being sharpened by this X-Acto pencil sharpener. Okay, I just finished sharpening about 70 pencils in a row, and let's take a look at how full this is. I think there's a lot of room for more pencil shavings. I love that. I love how big this vessel is right here. I'm gonna dump that out. Oh, those pencil shavings are so dirty, and we've got some here on the thing, and there. Okay, so what I usually do when I dump out a container like that is then I'll take my canned air and blow out the helix blade that's inside here. The engine doesn't even feel that warm. In fact, it might be warm just from my hand holding onto it. So I think you could sit down and do a couple hundred in a row and be safe here. I love that almost every size of pencil I have will fit in this, and I love how fast it is. 2 seconds and you're done. Now I'm going to sharpen a bunch through this guy right here and see how it performs compared to the Carl and to the X-Acto. I just finished sharpening 10 of these pencils here in this dolly, and I gotta say, it's after doing I don't know how many, almost 100 pencils in the X-Acto, I realized just how physically demanding a manual crank pencil sharpener is. Let's see how much. Oh, gonna make a mess. Okay. Oh, they were all stuck up inside there, so the crumbs weren't moving forward into the bin as I expected them to. So that made a mess. But, you know, that means it held pencil shavings for about 15 to 20 pencils before needing to be emptied. So that's something to keep in mind as far as maintenance and working with the dolly. Now the Carl, I want to revisit the Carl. It hasn't been working well for me lately because I think something is stuck up inside the helix blades. So I'm going to take this apart. So taking the Carl apart is super easy, and I think that the dolly will be the same way. We'll see here. Here you can see how the helix mechanism works, how it spins around and sort of carves off the wood and gets you a nice sharp point. Now there was a little tip that fell out as I was taking this apart, so that's what was jammed up inside. And honestly, this is the first time I've ever taken the Carl apart. And I've had it for ages, so that's pretty cool. So the pencil goes down in here, and then this sharpener goes around it like that, okay? So I'm gonna take this canned air and clean it off. And let's clean out this part too. It all looks pretty clean. Okay, and clean up this too. Woo! All right, now this is the graphite I was talking about that I bought. So it's actual powdered graphite inside this little bottle. If you want to purchase some of this, I'll put a link to it in the video description. But this stuff here, they use it for Pinewood Derby cars. It's basically creates a lubrication, a dry lubrication between anything mechanical. So this could work in the door if you've got a lock that's not working correctly. It can, anytime it's metal on metal sliding, or metal against wood, or wood against wood, all those situations, a little tiny bit of dry graphite lubricant is going to work really well to help those pieces and bits work better. So I'm going to, this is basically the same idea as using a graphite pencil and sending it through here. So I just want to get a bunch of it on here. Anywhere where metal is touching metal. And we'll just go like this, work in there. It's a messy little thing, but it actually works really good. We have a storm door in the front of our house, and the lock has been really finicky for a long time. So one of the first things I used this dry graphite on was that front door lock. And it says it, you know, just to be careful not to put too much on it, but once you do, it will function better, and it totally is working better. Okay, so the way this goes back in, there's a little notch right here of plastic, and it sets right into the notch on the body of it, and then we'll turn it to tighten it into place. So I've got it settled, and turn it to tighten. Okay. So that's, you know, I've pulled the Carl open this direction and blown it out before, but that's the first time I've ever taken it apart like that. So let's pull up some pencils. I'll just pull out five of them here. And let's run them through the Carl and see how it feels. So the Carl just feels stronger and more ergonomical, is that a word? As far as I'm rolling it this direction and I'm not hitting the table when I do it, and it has a bigger compartment for all of our shavings. So the only downfall of Carl versus Dahle is that Carl's mouth is a little smaller and it has those bitey teeth. The Dahle has a bit of a bigger mouth, so I can fit more bigger pencils, so I can fit bigger pencils in the hole without the little bitey marks. So which one out of these two would I recommend? You know, I haven't run 100 pencils through the Dahle yet, so I don't know if the plastic construction is a deal breaker or not. I like that it's not making bite marks. I like that it holds different size pencils. It looks like, yeah, it comes apart the same way that Carl does. Basically the same construction going on here. Let me clean this off while we're at it. So maintenance is easy and quick with both versions. Let's see if I can get it back together. I think because I've used Carl longer, I would recommend Carl because it's got a metal body, it feels more sturdy, and the cranking motion is more natural. But if you've got a lot of pencils that are of odd size and you're concerned about the bite marks, then the Dahle is the one that I would recommend. Very interesting. So in the end, what would I recommend? I recommend everyone own a two-hole comb. They are amazing. They fit almost every criteria on this list, and I think they're pretty foolproof. So I recommend you get a comb. After that, if you're like me and you have a large stash of pencils that you need to be maintaining on a regular basis, then you need to move up to one of these or an electric pencil sharpener. These two right here, the Carl and the comb, I've already told you, no, the Carl and the Dahle, I've already told you which one I prefer over the other here, but I'll keep using the Dahle as well and see how I like it. And this one I am super impressed with. I love that in 2 seconds I've got my pencil sharpened and I'm ready to go, so we can do large numbers of pencils quite quickly. I love that about this little electric pencil sharpener. But it's noisy. As you can see, Rose isn't here. She decided not to be a part of this video, which I totally respect her wishes and sent her on her way. But because it's only 2 seconds for a quick sharpening, I think she will forgive me when I need to use this one here. And if I ever need to do a bulk amount of pencils, I'll just put her in the other room so she won't be distressed by the pencil sharpener. I'm going to keep using these, and I'll give you an update in the future on how I like them. If there's a pencil sharpener you own and use that you think I need to check out and try, please comment below. I really, truly am looking for the perfect pencil sharpener, and I don't think any of them matched all 7 criteria. Some of them do really good one thing, and some of them do really good another thing. So I'm still on the hunt for the perfect pencil sharpener. But I think I'm getting closer, so I'm glad about that. Thanks for joining me, everyone. I hope you learned a little bit about pencil sharpening. Also, I highly recommend you check out this video that I'm going to link right now. It's a video that teaches you how to sharpen a pencil correctly using something like a Coombe pencil sharpener. And if you haven't learned how to do it correctly yet, you need to check out that video. I hope it's all helpful, and I hope you all have a wonderful, colorful, blissful day. Keep your pencils sharp. Bye-bye, everyone.